Please come now, I think I'm falling. My interest, my biggest interest in diving lies more in the technical side, in the deeper kind of stuff, and that's probably how I ended up finding the coelacanth, because that's what drives me, is the understanding of the science behind deeper diving. It comes from a dive club. I was a member of a dive club, and there were always the older guys in the club, and we were like the newbie guys listening to all these fantastic stories about nitrogen narcosis and everything, and then just dreaming of one day when we'd be able to go there. Yeah, we started actually looking for this fish in 1998. That's we had like an official expedition then. And on this expedition, we never managed to find one. In those days, we only knew of the Wright Canyon. So that's where we were diving. Subsequent to that expedition, about in the 2000, I think, we started diving in the Jesser Canyon, which is a bit closer to the beach than Wright Canyon. And on one of these dives, I had two students with me, and one of the students managed to spot actually the first coelacanth that ever were seen. So obviously, being a training diver, we had nothing to record this big moment with, so we planned another dive there a month later when we managed to get a hold of a camera that could dive to those depths. And we returned there and managed to find this fish again. And we actually got video footage of it, which we could now send to the guys with the great dust coats to agree or acknowledge that we did see a coelacanth. And then after that, there were stories of permits and all sorts of things, but eventually, moving on past that, we are now diving there quite a bit. We're discovering new stuff every time we go there, very, very interesting stuff. In fact, it's almost, I can say, the coelacanth sort of half moving into the background now, because there's so much other stuff to be done and to be seen. Stuff that's never been recorded here before. There's a couple of new species that are possible. Very, very interesting times actually now. When you see a coelacanth, it's almost it's got like a presence, you know. This is a serious fish that you're looking at, and it gives you the impression of looking at sort of like a Scud missile or something. You know, you can see this is it's got more of a presence than any other fish that you encounter. And I always like to say there's only three things that the coelacanth has in common from the beginning: is myself, Afrox, and the skipper that drives the boat when we dive. We've been here all the way. Sodwana Bay is one of the best places on the planet to dive. Many people say it's in the top 10. I think it is the top of the 10. So much so that if you go and dive on other places, you always end up being disappointed, because you're used to the best when you know, because it's on our back door, on our back doorstep. Please come on.